everyone. Good morning. Today is my graduation. I have literally just woke up right now. It is 7 in the morning. I need to be gone by 10 o'clock and it's like going to be a long drive to get to the place that the graduation is happening at. Oh my gosh, I am already stressing out because I have not done anything. My hair is not done. My makeup is not done. I even went to buy my clothes last minute yesterday.
Girl, goodbye.
So join me along this journey and see, what I do. Thank you. Bye. Anyways, for some of y'all that don't know what I was doing, I was doing my master's in international relations. And when I tell you this degree had me in chokehold, I mean it. I thought I was not gonna finish it, but here I am. Here I am graduating. It was tough. It was really tough, but I really thank God because he gave me the strength to finish what I did. And the crazy thing is that I was studying and at the same time I was working full time. So I would do 9 to 5 and then get home and then I would start my studies around 8 till 9 and then go back to work the following day. So it was just so hard and crazy, but I really thank God for what he has done. And I tell you what, I did not even know that I was gonna end up doing this master's. Who would have thought? But I did. And I can tell you it is truly the hand of God that has enabled me to do. And I'll give a story time about it later. So this is us driving there, a 2-hour drive going to the coast. So that's my sister and my friend. They went with me and so we were rushing because we're already late. We're an hour late. Get there and I get dressed with the gown and everything, and then
smile,
the ceremony starts.
Thank you for choosing Griffith University as a place to assist you in making your dreams a reality. And thank you for making Griffith University the unique and extraordinary place that it is. So well done, congratulations, good luck for whatever lies ahead, and stay in touch with us as you go about making a better future for us all and making it matter.
Deputy Chancellor, I certify to you that the candidates presented here today and in absentia have fulfilled the conditions prescribed by for admission to the named degrees of Griffith University and are entitled to be admitted to the rights, privileges and duties of these awards.
Vice Chancellor and President, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the University Council, I recognise the conferral of the candidates present and those absent, and welcome them to all the rights and privileges of being a Griffith University graduate.
Deputy Chancellor, I present graduates who have received awards from the following programs.
Master of Human Resource Management and Employment Relations, Rosalia Campbell. Belis Iribori.
The greatest, you can be the best, you can be the King Kong banging on your chest,
You can beat the world, you can win the war. You can talk to God, cold banging on his door.
Yep, that's me. I'll graduate and here we're just taking videos and photos. And that's me and my mom, and I'm just putting a cap on her just to say thank you. She's been my biggest motivator and she's made many sacrifices for me to get to where I am. And I truly thank her and I cherish her with my heart. That's my whole family. They obviously came through for me. But I don't know what they were doing here, either distracted or just camera shy, I don't know. But after that, we went to dinner or lunch, I don't know. But we had our lunch at a place called Koi in Broad Beach. He had some really good food, really good drinks. But I'm not gonna lie, it was just so overpriced because we ended up paying $800 for everybody here. But yeah, apart from that, everything else was so good and we loved the food.
They said in school,
Shut up. I need your face getting out of my video. Okay, where are we going? Kmart? Where?
Yes, Kmart. I'm pretty sure Kmart also has flowers.
I'm not going to buy flowers. We're going to buy flowers at Kmart.
Why don't you just get the flowers from the graduation?
What would I do that?
We're really old scratch dance. I hit my head on the side.
Okay, shut up. I'm stop my video.
Bruh, you basically already ruined the video at this point.
Hi everyone. Today is my second day after the graduation. We got here yesterday very late. It was around maybe it wasn't really late. It was like 10. But the drive was really long. We had to drive for 2.5 hours to the place and coming back. So everybody got here really tired. I was exhausted. Everyone was exhausted. We just slept once we got here. But yeah, today I am going to visit my dad. He's passed. He's already passed. But I thought I should just, try and honor him in this video, try and include him in this video because he has been a very big part of my education and just my whole motivation to study. He's been the number one person that motivated me to get to where I am and where I have reached. So I'll be just going to the shops to get flowers and yeah, we'll go to my dad's and just visit him for a little while. Come along. Anyways, I did talk about how my dad was my biggest motivator in my education, but I didn't actually say how. But yeah, he's been the biggest motivator in my life ever since I was a kid. He did everything that he could. Obviously, him and my mom. But as the fact that he's no longer here, it happened, but things happen. But I still do remember the many stuff that he taught me and encouraged me. And I remember that just before he passed, me and him would sit down and be like, oh, you know, I was around 14 years of age, and he would, you know, tell me, we would sit down and count the many more years I had until I was maybe 18, graduating, finishing high school, finishing uni and all that. But obviously that did not end up happening. He never lived to see me reach that far. And one of the last wishes that he had for me was to graduate and obviously study. Where are we? Okay, yes, we go this way. And I remember just before he passed away, he sent me a video to watch, and it was about this girl that was graduating. And I remember he asked me about it, and he was like, did you watch the video? And I was like, oh, yes, I did. But to tell you the truth, I hadn't watched it. I was like, oh, you know, here goes his many talks about education and stuff. But once he passed away, I went through his different messages that we had. And the last video he had was of him showing me that video, you know, sending me that video. And that was the only thing I had left from him. So I watched the whole lot, and the girl was, you know, talking about how her dad or mom had passed away, and you know, she ended up, you know, achieving all this many educational milestones and stuff like that. And I watched it, and I promised him that I would also do the same and achieve one of the things that he wanted me to achieve. And so I am truly grateful for him. I am grateful that he has been in the journey of my education. Although he is not here with us to really celebrate my achievements and witness the things that he fought for a while for us to achieve, I do believe that wherever he is proud of me, and he is proud of all the milestones that I have also achieved. So yeah, thank you. That was my whole graduation journey and stuff like that. Thanks for watching. Bye.